Hi, welcome to Japan Objects. My name is Billy Matsunaga and I'm a professional kimono teacher living in Kumamoto, Japan. In this video, I want to share some yukata styling tips with you. I wear kimono and yukata for so many years now, and I always have the feeling that there is a lack of information out there about how to style your yukata more fashionable. So today I want to share some experience and advice with you, and I hope it helps you. Choose a color that suits you. I always get a lot of questions about what kind of color should I buy? Is there a meaning behind those colors? Or is there a certain color for a certain age? And the answer is, don't worry so much about that. There were meanings for colors centuries ago, but those meanings got lost with the time, and now we have yukata in any color you could think of. So my advice is, choose a color you like. Of course, some people say you should choose brighter color for fairer skin to look more fresh and youthful, and deeper colors for deeper complexions. But in my personal opinion, I really think you should choose a color you like, because colors you like are usually those colors you feel comfortable and confident in, which are surprisingly then also those colors that suits you because you feel comfortable and confident in those colors. Pick the right belt for your yukata. Traditionally, of course, you would wear an obi with your yukata, which is a kimono belt. But you don't have to. You could, for example, wear a very long scarf instead of a kimono belt and then just tie and drape it nicely. Or you could also wear your yukata with leather belts, and this also looks very, very casual and fashionable. When I'm choosing my obi for my yukata or kimono, I often use the trick to choose a controversy color. Like right now, I wear a red yukata with a blue obi, and I know this is definitely going to work out. Another trick is to pick up a color from the yukata. For example, when you have a black yukata with a lot of orange flowers on it, you could pick up one of those orange tones for your obi, and this will just match together so beautifully. And when you really want to dress up, you could, for example, wear a sambun himo with your yukata and pair this with an obidome. A sambun himo is very, very close to a shoelace, so you could just use a very long shoelace and then just pin a brooch on it, because obidome are very close to usual brooches. You don't need a special kimono underwear. Yes, there is a special kimono underwear out there, but you don't have to purchase it or search for it for a long time or even sew it by yourself, because just a normal tank top, probably white is a good color for that, and usual shorts should do the same thing. If you have a long skirt you really like, there is no reason why you couldn't wear this under your yukata. You could also even show a little of the hem, and this would create your really own look. Usually wear this underwear under your kimono or yukata to have most sweat absorbed by it, so your yukata or your kimono won't become that sweaty. So when you choose a very absorbent fabric, you will feel more comfortable. So cotton or linen is very good, and synthetic fabrics are something you should be avoiding. Wear comfortable shoes is my favorite advice to give you. I know you think when I wear yukata or kimono, I have to wear those Japanese sandals called geta. And I'm totally with you, they are beautiful and they really, really make your outfit so super traditional Japanese. But believe me, when you wear them for the first time or the first time a whole day, your feet will hurt so much, especially when you walk a lot. I still have sometimes problems with my geta, so I am actually a fan of wearing normal sandals with your yukata, and I really think This makes you look very nice, very fresh, and very casual. One thing I want to mention is that when you wear your hem of the yukata a little shorter, it's easier to walk in yukata when you combine it with sandals. Easy and elegant yukata hairstyles. For me, it doesn't change if you wear a yukata or a normal dress or a t-shirt. The hair is the thing that completes your outfit. You have this beautiful neckline with yukata, so I usually wear my hair up to show this nice neckline. But if I really don't have any time or I want to create a more casual look, a ponytail works really fine as well. But believe me, a bun can work wonders for your outfit. You can also add some floral hairpins or a so-called kansashi, and this will also make you look more vibrant and will draw a lot of attention to your hair. By the way, pretty fashionable in Japan these days are also hats with your yukata. So why don't you give that a try too? Go bold with accessories. I think I'm already pretty well known for my never-ending collection of big earrings. And this is because yukata and kimono cover most of your accessories. So earrings are a really nice eye-catcher. Also, bracelets are a wonderful accessories, especially because yukata sleeves tend to be too short for a non-Japanese body. The length of the sleeves, by the way, is called yuki, and it is the length between the middle of your neck to your wrist. And to tell you some numbers, mine is 72 centimeters. And most yukata end at 68, which means I always have to cover those 4 centimeters. And bracelets really help you in that case, and it looks really, really nice. Another problem with yukata, or especially women's clothes in general, is that they have no pockets. So a nice clutch or a rattan bag are a very elegant and nice solution. Do not tie yourself in knots. I am often asked if kimono or yukata are uncomfortable, and the answer is no, not at all. When you feel uncomfortable in your yukata, this means you probably did something wrong when putting it on. But that's natural when you are a kimono beginner. And I had the same problems when I was starting with my kimono life. It really helped me when I changed from normal ties to kimono elastics. There are special kimono elastics, but you don't have to purchase them. You could just use a normal elastic you can buy at a sewing supply store. When I have to dress up a lot of people and don't have enough kimono elastics for it, I often use these elastics to dress people up, and it totally works. If you want to know how to put on a yukata, check out my other video, how to wear a yukata and use elastics instead of ties. The secrets to staying graceful. Looking graceful in your yukata is probably the hardest thing to master, and believe me, I try very, very hard every day. Here are some advice that could help you with staying graceful in your yukata. First is the question, how to walk properly in a yukata. And the answer is, there is absolutely no special way. It looks best when you walk as normally in your yukata. Sometimes you might feel it's a bit too tight. This could also be that you wrapped your yukata too tight around your body, so it helps when you loosen it just a little. When sitting down, swipe with your hand over your butt to avoid wrinkles. Do not sit too deep into the seat so your belt arrangement won't get crushed. And one thing that will probably take a while when you're new to wearing yukata are the very long sleeves. Usually when you reach out for something, you would hold the middle of the sleeve up like this, and then you reach out for things. And when you do this, your sleeves won't end up in cream, sauce, or whatever is there. I really hope these tips could help you and you know feel more confident and comfortable when wearing your yukata. There is just one thing I want you to keep in mind. when wearing yukata, have fun with it. There are no limits. If you want to learn more about kimono, yukata, styling tips from experts, or to buy an authentic kimono and kimono belt like this, check out japanobjects.com. And I also have more kimono advice on my own YouTube channel, Billy Matsunaga. Thank you so much for watching, and watch out for more kimono tutorials from Japan Objects. Bye!